Next, let's look at atrial flutter. On an ECG, atrial flutter resembles sawtooth-like F waves. This is the result of an ectopic atrial pacemaker or because of a rapid reentry pathway somewhere within the atria, albeit outside the SA node area. The origin of this ectopic pacemaker is usually somewhere in the lower atrium and closer to the AV node, thereby resulting in a distinct wave pattern. Due to this erratic electrical activity, the normal function of the SA node is usually suppressed and non-effective. So instead of P waves, atrial flutter produces flutter waves. And as a result of the depolarization of the atria in an abnormal manner, the classic F waves or atrial flutter resemble this sawtooth pattern. Let's take a closer look at the ECG now. Is the rhythm regular or irregular? It's variable depending on the ratio of F waves to QRS complexes. When we look at the rate, we say, well, what is the rate? The rate also is variable. Is the rate normal, fast, or slow? The rate is variable because of its irregularity. Next, let's evaluate the P wave. Are they present? Anything closely resembling a P wave is actually a sawtooth type F wave. Do they occur regularly? No, because there are no real SA node P waves. Is there one P wave for each QRS complex? Again, no. There's no P wave for each QRS complex. Are the P waves smooth, rounded, and upright? Again, that doesn't apply because they're sawtooth in shape. Do all P waves have similar shapes? Again, no. Now, what we want to know about the PR interval is, does the PR interval fall within the normal 0.12 to 0.20 seconds? Well, of course, no, because it's variable. Is the PR interval constant? No. So now we move on to the QRS complex of the ECG. Is the QRS interval less than 0.12 seconds? Yes, it is. The QRS is within normal range. Is the QRS wide or narrow? In this case, the QRS is narrow. Are the QRS complexes similar in appearance? Now we can see here that each one does look similar. So what is the cardiac interpretation from this ECG? Structural heart disease is the usual cause of atrial flutter. In the same way that atrial fibrillation complicates adequate ventricular preload filling, atrial flutter complicates circulation, especially when accompanied by a syndrome called rapid ventricular response. The faster the ventricular response, the more the circulation will be compromised.